It's a hell of a ride. Hope you enjoy it.
Hold it!
Steady.
Stagecoach, 1939. Well, you can't really talk about the Western genre without naming John Ford. This is one of his most famous movies, and the first one he shot in and around Monument Valley, where he was later to make several movies. This is a movie that made a star-leaning man out of John Wayne. He has an impressive entrance in this movie, his character.
Hello, Curly.
He plays a cowboy gunslinger who's had some problems with the law. The movie also stars Claire Trevor, John Carradine, Thomas Mitchell.
I'm happy, Greenwood.
Really interesting characters. In a way, when you look at this movie now, you might be forgiven for thinking that these characters are cliches. This is where those kinds of characters originated. And furthermore, John Ford handles them really well. None of the characters, in a way, end up being or doing what you expect them to do. And it's also famous for a really wild chase scene. This sequence also includes maybe the stunt sequence that the movie's most famous for, the Yakima Kanat, legendary stunt performer. He goes under a bunch of running horses and somehow lives to tell the tale. I don't know how he did that. If I should die before I wake. This movie is a disturbing sort of fairy tale told from the point of view of a young boy named Lucho, whose father is a policeman. Lucho is a bit of a prankster, kind of class clown in the beginning of the story. And I won't ruin the movie for you, but there's been several young girls about Lucho's age have disappeared recently in the area. And the last of these to disappear is a friend of Lucho's. A girl who had told him, sworn him to secrecy, but she had told him that she had met a man who lives in the woods near the park where the kids play, and he had given her lollipops and promised to show her his house full of candy. But she made Lucho promise not to tell anyone. When she disappears, he's of course torn between keeping his promise to her and notifying his father, who's a policeman. Lucho initially tries to track down the killer himself. Anyway, I recommend it. It's a good story. Might make you think of Hansel and Gretel. It might remind you of Fritz Lang's M. And in some sense, in terms of its imagery and its tone, the suspense and so forth, it reminded me of Charles Laughton's Night of the Hunter as well. La Pointe Courte, 1954. I've long been a fan of this director's work, Agnes Varda. I like this movie because it's a very low-budget movie, but it's well shot, really well edited, has a nice pace to it. It's an unusual story. There's a fishing village in the south of France, which is called La Pointe Courte, like the title. And all the people in this village, what's going on in their lives, they're banned from fishing and where they usually go fishing by the government, and that's a problem for them. These are all non-actors, which was unusual in a French movie in the 1950s. And their story is contrasted with the maybe central story of a man and a woman who are having relationship problems, and we hear them talking about that. One last thing about Varda. She once said to me, I was lucky to meet her towards the end of her life, and it was shortly before I directed my first movie. And she asked me what I was up to, what I was going to do next. And I said, well, I'm going to direct my first movie. She said, oh, good. She goes, make sure you don't show the audience anything. And I said, it's a visual medium. What do you mean, don't show the audience anything? And she said, what I mean is, don't show them, but create in them, by virtue of your storytelling skills, a desire to see things. Don't show them, make them want to see for themselves. Seemed like very good advice, and I have tried to follow that in both movies I directed, and and we'll always keep that in mind. The Great Santini, this movie is special. It's a kind of a twisted comedy, but it has some intense confrontation scenes, especially between father and son, played by Robert Duvall and Michael O'Keefe. It's a movie that when I first saw it, I was really impressed by the acting from Duvall, O'Keefe, but also Blythe Danner. The Great Santini is a nickname given to Robert Duvall's character. He's a lieutenant colonel in the Marine Corps and an ace pilot. And his fellow Marines have given him the nickname the Great Santini. He considers himself a great leader, and maybe is, maybe he isn't. At the heart of the story is the father-son confrontation between Duvall and O'Keefe, and really well acted. Anyway, I hope you enjoy this movie. I really did strongly recommend it.